The design is what takes precedence with the Vivo Y95. So in a nutshell, it's a better looking and a bit more affordable version of Vivo V9 Pro that recently launched in India. But there's more to it than simply being an eye candy. So for starters, this is the first Snapdragon 439 phone that we've experienced, and it has a water drop notch that houses a 20 megapixel selfie cameras. So these things are very popular these days, and they're also quite rare for affordable phones still. So for an approximate price of 16,000 INR, this will go up against the likes of Redmi Note 6 Pro and the Zenfone Max 2 Pro, the Realme U1. So is it a worthy competitor? Is it a good buy? Well, we have been using the Vivo Y95 for around 2 weeks now and are ready to now answer all such questions. So let's get done with our Vivo Y95 full review. And before we do that, do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon below. What basically sets the Y95 apart from other affordable Vivo phones that we saw this year is its tiny water drop notch and the gradient back pattern. While these features may or may not work for you, but it cannot be denied that these are in trend these days, and many young consumers specifically ask for them. If you wish to know our subjective opinion, well, you're fine with the notch, but the nebula purple gradient pattern on the back panel is a little too flashy for our taste. If you'd rather prefer something sober, there's a starry black color option too. The bezels surrounding the screen are mostly slim, save for the chin at the bottom. Ergonomically, the Y95 has curved side edges and is quite comfortable to handle. The rear panel liberally attracts finger smudges, but it's not slippery. The fingerprint sensor on the rear is readily accessible, and the SIM tray has a separate card slot. At the bottom, you'll find a regular USB port, mono speaker grill, and the audio jack. Overall, it's a well-designed and solidly built phone. Let's talk a bit more about the display. The HD Plus resolution on the large 6.22-inch IPS LCD panel feels kind of inadequate. The text on the screen isn't very sharp, but perhaps this isn't something untrained eyes will immediately notice. The color and contrast are just fine, and we could switch to more agreeable and pleasant warmer tones from a color temperature adjustment option under display settings. The maximum brightness is just average, and so is the visibility under direct sunlight. So summing it up, the Y95 screen is strictly mediocre. Since this is the first Snapdragon 439 phone that we have tested, we were quite curious to know how the Y95 performs. We totally understand that that might very well be the reason why many of you are watching this review in the first place. Well, theoretically, the Snapdragon 439 has a bit more raw processing power than the Snapdragon 450, but dials back on other SoC components like the modem, GPU, etc. It's the first 12nm process-based chipset from Qualcomm compared to 14nm on the Snapdragon 450. And it has two Cortex A53 cores clocked at 1.9 GHz and other 6 performance cores clocked at 1.45 GHz. Other than that, there's ample RAM and storage in the phone and a dedicated card slot that can be used to freely add more of secondary storage. The benchmark scores are close to what we get on the Snapdragon 450 phones, and so is the real world performance. The day-to-day usage is mostly smooth but not blazing fast. App launch time and multitasking are reasonable too. As for gaming, well, we could play games like Asphalt 9 and PUBG, but barely so. The stutters and lags were quite prominent. Unfortunately, the handset does not support dual 4G or dual 4G VoLTE, so you can access 4G on only one SIM slot at a time. Other than that, the call quality and connectivity were fine in our area. The fingerprint sensor on the phone is fast, and so is the face unlock. So unlocking the phone is quite convenient. The software is the familiar Fun Touch OS based on Android 8.1 Oreo. It's iOS-like, but it's feature-rich, well-optimized, and at this point in time, it's quite mature. Two areas where we'd like Vivo to work on is the notch and HD streaming. In spite of that tiny notch, there's barely room on the status bar for app icons. It's mostly occupied by system icons. And like all other Vivo phones in India, this one also does not support HD streaming on apps like Netflix and Amazon Prime. Testing the Vivo Y95 camera, we were instantly reminded of the V9 Pro. The two phones are quite similar in this regard. The camera specs are quite customary. There's a 30 megapixel primary sensor on the rear, paired with a basic 2 megapixel depth sensor. On the front, you get a more generous 20 megapixel selfie camera. And about the rear camera performance, well, the quality is strictly average. In proper outdoor lighting, the camera can lock focus quickly, get the right exposure,
and capture ample details more often than not. The low-light camera performance, however, isn't much to write home about, and the portrait mode is mostly a miss. The selfie camera is relatively a better performer, and we did manage to capture a few good ones in proper lighting. The camera software is quite fun actually. There are numerous shooting modes and a ton of features that you can experiment with. Now let's talk about the battery. Battery backup is excellent. The 4030mAh battery on the phone can easily last for moderate to heavy usage day, and then some. Vivo bundles a 5W 2A charger in the box, and that takes around 2.5 hours to completely charge the battery. So fast charging isn't supported. The audio output via headphones and via loudspeakers is above average.
Now to answer the big question, should you or should you not buy the Vivo Y95? The handset has a trendy design, long-lasting battery, and a dedicated card slot. The performance can't match up to the best available online alternatives, but it should still be good enough for basic users, even in the long run. On the downside, there's no dual 4G support, the display resolution is low, and the camera quality is strictly average. So as we stated at the start, the Y95 is basically a trimmed down version of the V9 Pro, and we'd recommend you go for the latter if you can spend the extra $1,000. If you are an online buyer, we'd recommend that you skip this one and go for one of the other powerful options available in the same budget. If you're a basic user and you need to buy from an offline store, you might very well consider the Y95 as an option.